This is just saying it's a gasoline or diesel, it's not electric. I just do what they tell me to do.
People like the trucks that didn't have it before they started it. But I know it causes some issues with trucks sometimes.
Yes. Hethens? Is that you? What's going on, you spoo heathens? What's going on, baby? Let me tell you something. Today is a special day. I got a big surprise for you guys in store. Obviously, you see it in the title. You know what's going on. It's approximately 8:38 a.m. We got an appointment at 9:30. We got to go by the dump, drop the little one off, and it's going to be a good day. I wish I could have got a chop beforehand, you know what I mean? But we got one at 11 today. We're going to get a new truck today. This has been in the works for a few weeks, longer than a few weeks, you know. The story is, I'll probably tell it later in the video, I don't know. But it's been a crazy story. It's time to get a new truck, man. As you guys know, I'm riding around in a 2012 F-250, or if you didn't know, it's a 2012 F-250 two-wheel drive near Cleveland, Ohio. Makes absolutely no sense, but it's what I got started to... is what I got started to to start the business, and I was smart about it. I bought it cash. It was I got it for a really good deal. Truck and trailer combo. But like I said, it's time to upgrade. You gotta know your business is gonna tell you, you know, a great mentor told me your business is gonna let you know when it's time to make a move, and my business let me know. I had a, you know, intuitive feeling that it's time to do it, so I made it happen. It was not an easy process. It was definitely not an easy process. But something about me is I get shit done no matter what. That's what we're doing. We're off now to drop the baby off, as I said, and head to the dealership. Let's go. All right. I thought it was going to be a little cooler this morning. We going to take this.
See you, baby. Bye-bye.
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 Take these shirts off. Switch shirts, as I said, it's a little bit.
Y'all can't see all this good then. Hold on. Y'all can't see all this good then.
Come on, much better.
Now we're cooking with a little peanut oil, yeah, man.
So here's the backstory, guys. Originally, I knew I was gonna need a new truck and also a second truck. I'm having issues with my Google Ads company, and if they would get their asses up to speed. This is a side note, but I've already, you know, I've got established in the community now. So people know I have a good return customer basis. We're getting a lot of jobs off of MatPack, organic leads. My Google Ads company, I don't know what the hell they're doing. So anyway, that's a side note. But I said all that to say that I know I'm going to need a second truck soon, a second crew. So I knew it was time to get one. So this started back like 2 months ago, back in July, early July. I was looking, I was on the prowl, I went to a Chevrolet dealership out where I'm at, and he was getting a trade-in from a guy that was giving two 2019 Isuzu MPRs, junk trucks, like the ones that's made how they're supposed to be made for junk removal. And they both had, like, one had 80,000, the other one had 110. The 80,000 one was in really, really good shape. It just is obviously going to need a fresh coat of paint, and my color, olive green paint that I get. So we were working on that. It was going to be a great deal. I was going to get it for, like, $35,000. I had my dad come up here and look at it, and we drove it. It was in really good shape. It was a gasser. So all was well. Long story short, it ended up being a title issue with it, a mistake. The guys was dragging me along for weeks. I had already put a deposit down on it. It was all gonna work. Ended up falling through. So after that happened, a month goes by. I get my deposit back. I go work with a different Chevrolet dealership. Again, I had saw a steak body, double cab, brand new Isuzu, LCF 4500. I didn't need the double cab, but they're hard to even come by at all, any Isuzu. So I was like, okay. We were working on that. The steak body wasn't a dump. We were going to get a dump added to it. And then he had a guy that was willing to trade in Pennsylvania, I believe. They had one there with a Morgan body on it. It was nice. It was kind of higher price, but I knew I wanted it. The trade was going to happen in a couple of days, like 2 or 3 days went by. Everything was good to go. And he reaches back out to me on the day that they were supposed to go pick it up. And he's like, hey, man, so the steak body that they were going to trade at that dealership to get the one that I wanted from Pennsylvania for me, the catalytic converters had been cut off of them for the second time. So I had already put my deposit down on that. I'm like, bro, this is crazy. First of all, the first dealership, Gaylon Chevrolet, in where I'm at, they sucked ass. I'm sorry, they were terrible. The salesman there was no good. I mean, they just, I don't know if they, you know, I felt like I wasn't a top priority, which that's fine. I know you probably have bigger clients, but at the end of the day, you know, my philosophy in life is you either suck or you're great. You're great or you suck. You're good at what you do, you're great at what you do, or you suck. Anywhere in between, you suck, because nobody remembers people who's good. They remember people who's really, really good, slash great, or they remember you if you suck. So there's no in between, they sucked. So I couldn't believe this fell through. My guy today that ended up getting the job done, Mark, you guys will meet soon, or you'll see soon later in the video. He ended up getting it done. Well, later that day, Mark gives me a call as I go home, and I'm sitting there like, dude, this is gonna work out. He finds this truck, bada bing, bada boom, a week goes by, the truck's delivered, we're going to pick it up today. So that's how we got to where we're at today. That's the story. It has been a crazy roller coaster. Not a great experience, but you have to do, you know, the moral of the story is you have to do what you have to do to get things done. Nobody's going to get anything done. Nobody cares about the struggles you go through except for you. And it's up to you to get it done. Sometimes it ain't going to be an easy pass. Most of the time, it's not going to be an easy path. But you have to do what you have to do to get the shit done. So I did that. We going to pick this thing up. Let's see what we got. Let's see what kind of truck we got.
Mira. Have you ever felt inside that just being alive is why some niggas die? That's the type of shit a nigga hit inside. Think about that shit soon as I get inside. Sitting in my room, I just sit and cry. It's been a while since they asked me how I feel inside. If I reply, they'd be surprised at how I'm still alive. Anxiety hugging my windpipes, feel like I'm finna die.
This is just saying it's a gasoline or diesel, it's not electric. I just do what they tell me to do. Saying we don't owe you anything in addition.
The one with that Morgan body, that was gonna be more. I saw their website, they had a list of like 86K. That was gonna be more? The first one we were gonna get, or no? You don't remember?
I don't remember. We went through so many different ones.
All right, guys, so we just finished all the paperwork. We're currently waiting for them to bring that pretty little thing around. I'm excited. It's been a long time coming to get here. This is one of many, hopefully, to come. Let's see what we got, man. Let's see what we got.
People
like
the trucks that didn't have it before they started it. But I know it causes some issues with trucks sometimes.
Okay, I'm fucking with her intellect. Her head game off the charts. Some niggas scared to get their money. Guess them niggas were at the store. I'm partying with gambler playing spades. He lost his life for playing cards. Where I'm from, you might get ate alive if you ain't still for hard. If we get caught together and that's my work, then I'ma take my charge. I'm with my A-Rap out in Cali and we somewhere on the farm. I don't do that plain Jane shit. I'm busting down my charm. Just to show the gang I love them, I got it tatted on my